I want to thank you all for being here today. I want to thank Jerry Mosca and Michael Costa of the Huntington Animal Shelter, Ginny Munger Khan and Barbara Buscarino, who are with LI Dog. And of course, our special guests, Winslow and Lexi. A study by the Center for Disease Control entitled Which Dogs Bite found that chained and tethered dogs are 2.8 times more likely to bite. Our new anti-tethering legislation that was sponsored by me and enacted by the town board at yesterday's meeting is designed to better protect the health, welfare, and safety of Huntington residents and their animals. Why is tethering bad for dogs? Dogs are, as you can see, naturally social beings that require interactions with humans or other animals. Intensive confinement or long-term restraint can severely damage their physical and psychological well-being. An otherwise friendly and docile dog, when kept continuously chained or intensively confined in any way, can become neurotic, unhappy, anxious, and then aggressive, sort of like us in the winter, right? The dangers of tethering. Tethering is not only harmful to dogs, it's a high risk factor, as we said, for serious dog bites against owners and others. Dogs that are tethered are unable to retreat due to approaching threats can act out aggressively, highly aggressively. Dogs are territorial by nature. When confronted with a perceived threat, they respond accordingly with their fight or flight instinct. Tragically, the ones who are often the victims of such attacks are children who are unaware of the risks. Under this legislation, it prohibits tethering, leashing, fastening, securing, or restraining, chaining, or tying a dog to a stationary object outdoors for more than 2 continuous hours in any 12-hour period. For animals who are restrained, the new law, among other requirements, bans the use of a choke collar and requires that the restraint be at least 10 feet for a running able trolley and 15 feet for a tether to a stationary object and long enough to give the dog continuous access to food, water, and shelter. In addition to these new amendments, dog owners are required for the first time to poop or scoop after their dogs by placing pet waste in sealed plastic bags and depositing the bag in a covered garbage receptacle. Of course, we know almost all responsible dog owners do that anyway, but for those who would flaunt the laws, there are fines for a first, second, and third offense. I want to thank again Barbara Buscarino and Ginny Munger Khan of the Long Island Dog Group for being here, and would ask them if they want to make any comments to please join me.
We want to thank Councilman Cuthbertson so much for sponsoring this legislation. We strongly support these anti-tethering laws. As Mark explained, they are bad for both the dogs and for people. We also really are thrilled that the town has passed this provisions that will allow officers to get dogs out of hot cars. This is really important and will save lives. So again, thank you. And we fully support laws that require people to pick up after their dogs immediately. This is a basic responsibility of dog ownership, and we're happy to support that as well, obviously. So we want to just thank the town board and Councilman Cuthbertson for passing this law that will help improve the welfare of animals in the town of Huntington.
I'd just like to give a big thank you to Councilman Cuthbertson. As he mentioned, we were just discussing earlier, we both started this effort, I think, back in the late 90s. We were both in the first Huntington Leadership Program together, and so Mark was approachable for me to discuss, you know, getting more opportunities for dog owners to utilize dog parks or create dog parks or walk in town. And I think it's just this effort, this updating of the town code is just part of that continuing effort of making Huntington a much more dog friendly place. And although I know Mark may not be a huge dog owner or anything, he's just doing what good government does, and he's working for the constituents of the town, and that is a growing number of dog owners. So we thank him so much for his efforts to make Huntington a better place for all the dog owners and their dogs. Thank you so much.
And I want to just end by a special thank you to Barbara and Ginny, who they're the people who have so much knowledge in this area that made this such a collaborative and great effort. weren't able to accomplish everything I think we wanted to, but I think it's a start, and it's a great start for us. They have told me, and I knew the stats, that pet ownership is up so much in our country. It's such an important part of the fabric of our families. So it's important that our laws are updated to address it. So we thank them. We thank the staff here at the shelter. And we also thank the Humane Society that was a part of this and the many people in Town Hall who crafted this legislation. So thank you very much and enjoy this beautiful day.
Thank you.